What's up, everyone? It is Fido from Self-Taught Hustle back at it again. Really happy to be working on the boilerplate project that we started over the weekend. And essentially what we did is that we set up a basic project that is designed to be installed quickly via hard hat so that you can customize code effectively. What that means is that you can get started coding without having to reinvent a wheel or reinvent the wheel and focus more on the actual application that you want to build. So this helps us get started a little bit faster, and it's designed to be used, or Hard Hat designs it to be used for scenarios like when you are in a hackathon as a coder, right? So what we did in our last video is that we deployed a smart contract to the testnet that Hard Hat provides us, right? This is a localized test network that we have here on our machine. And effectively, what we are going to be doing now that we've deployed that contract in this video is that we are going to be installing the front end of the application, right? So to do that, we will actually get started here. We'll read these instructions. So where we last left off is us effectively deploying the smart contract, which is what you see here on the right-hand side of your screen, right? So let's keep reading here. So it says, this will deploy the contract to Hard Hat Network. After this completes, run CD front end. Okay, so it looks like we're going to CD into the front end. And the front end is here. So it's this directory here. So we're going to go inside of that directory, front end. Okay, and this is, we're now in the front end of the application, okay? So in here, what we're going to do is that we're going to write npm install, which is interesting because it comes with its own dependencies. So npm install. Okay, let me see here. Okay, so now we're installing a bunch of dependencies. If you've ever worked with an MVC design pattern on a framework, this front end is kind of like the view folder for the project. Let me see. Looks like it's installing pretty quickly this time around. Let's see what other files are in there. So there is a there's a public file, a package.json, and then there's also a source file. We could look at it in here while it installs, which is right here. So here are the dependencies that we're installing. The source folder looks like it has an index.js. So it's probably because of those dependencies, it's probably running some sort of framework on the front end. Let me see. Okay, so it looked like it installed. Let me see. Okay, so we got an install. Now, let's see what it says here. To start the React web app, open. Okay, so now all we have to do in our application is to go ahead and point to this endpoint here. Actually, it looks like it does it automatically by doing that in your browser, and you should see this. Okay. Go ahead, let's run that again. And I am not seeing that. All right, why am I not seeing it? Node modules. I guess I'm not getting an error anywhere too. To start the React, So to start the React web app, open, which is like the localhost address with a port number of 3000 in your browser, and you should see this. Set your network in MetaMask to 127.0.0.0. Huh. Well, yeah, I mean, that totally makes sense, but the problem is it's not shown here. And I'm not exactly sure why. So in that case, what we're going to do is that we're going to just kill this. We're going to kill this node modules folder. We're going to delete. And then we're going to try to redo that install. And maybe Well, no, I think this has to be running here. And the reason why they ask you to open up a new terminal is because this is the actual testnet being working, right? It's kind of like if you've ever done an application in Node.js, when you have to, you essentially, when you install a module called NodeMon, you essentially have a server that's running on an ongoing basis in order for you to be able to execute changes to your code. And this is kind of what's happening here, where I think this is just the network running in the background, and effectively we're making changes now that it's running in the background, or at least it should be, when we install that the dependencies for the front end and point to local and point localhost to the port number where the network is being served on it, then we should be able to see the application, something like that. It's pretty rough, but I think that that's how it's supposed to be working. Now the problem is that it's not working. So what we're going to do here is we are going to actually, we're going to kill this and we're going to rerun the command there. So we're going to say npx hardhat node. Okay. And npx hardhat node starts the network. Okay. And then we're going to hit enter there. Oh, enter here. Okay. All right. And now we started the network, kind of like when you go to start a server in Node. And now that that's done, in this, we're going to cd out of the front end. Okay. So we're going to just redo this. Okay. We're going to cd out of the front end. And well, I mean, I think the contract's already deployed. I don't know if we have to redeploy the contract. Let's go ahead and do the deploy again, just in case the network doesn't. For some reason, I think we have to redeploy the contract. I'm not sure if the network saves the fact that the contract was initially deployed, but we'll try it again. So npx hardhat network localhost run deploy. Yeah. Okay. Cool. So all right. So it looks like it accepted us redeploying that contract. And now what we're going to do is we're going to get back into that front end directory, and then we're going to run npm install. And I think, guys, I think I forgot to run this command here, npm run start. I don't think I ran that. And you guys could tell me in the comment section below, but I literally don't think I ran this npm run start command, and that's why I didn't point to anything. Okay, so that's that's why the browser didn't show an application when I tried to open it here. All right, so let's run npm run start. Yeah. Because look, so this is what it is. So that run start, there's probably a let me see here in this package.json. There's probably a script either here or I think there's, oh, here. There's probably a script somewhere in here. Okay. And that's this command here, the npm run start. This is that same command. So it's npm run start. And what it does is it runs a React script. So React scripts and then start. It's just like a shorthand way of calling it via the terminal. So that's actually effectively what starts the application. But we're going to start it over here because this is what's running the network. I guess what's kind of weird, what feels kind of weird is having two running the application with two terminals, but that's fine. Okay, so we're going to run npm run start. Oh, here, let me clear some of this junk so it's just easy for you guys to see. Okay, so we're going to run npm run start like this. Okay, now, see, so now the front end is up. Terminal wants to access control Google Chrome, and then we say okay. Oh, we're so close, and it's not a lot. Oh, it's because the version of Node is 17.5. So my guess is that this folder, when it executed, so something in this directory is looking, most likely something in the dependencies is looking for the version 16 of of Node, and we're gonna change it here by saying, well, let's actually check it, the version. So okay, so the version is set to 17.5, and I think I saw a command back way earlier in the tutorial that actually allowed us to permanently, or at least so long as we're working on the development in the development directory. So like the, so long as we're working in this specific project, that the version would stay 16 even after we exited the application. I might have skipped it. I think I skipped that part, and that's why I'm having to continually emphasize that we want to use 16. Luckily, NBM makes it very easy to switch to another version of Node. So NBM use 16. Okay, and now what we're going to do is that we are going to go ahead and run the script. So npm run start, we're going to hit enter, and I think we should get it to work this time. Starting the development server. Let's see here. Okay, you can now view front end in the browser. Okay, cool. So there you go, guys. So now we are officially able to look at the application here on the front end. In the next video, and I'm not sure if I'm going to record this particular part. I'll probably do it, but I'm going to be entering some information to access the MetaMask. I'll see if I end up recording it or not. I have to kind of think about what's going to be feasible for being able to display to you guys. But nonetheless, we've successfully compiled, and you are now able to view the boilerplate application. And it's pretty cool because this is a regular browser based application, but on the back end we're running an Ethereum testnet. So pretty wicked. Nonetheless, guys, thank you so much for riding along in this video. I am looking forward to recording the next one, and I will see you then.